And welcome back. Happy Tuesday morning to you, everyone. Welcome back to Morning Musings. My name is Don K. Preston. I am the president of Preterist Research Institute of Ardmore, Oklahoma. We are currently involved in sharing with you a study of the nature of the kingdom. Throughout his parabolic teaching, Jesus said repeatedly, the kingdom of heaven is like. And when we look at his parabolic teaching, we soon discover that how Jesus describes the kingdom has no resemblance to what people today, all three futurist views of eschatology, as a matter of fact, teach about the nature of the kingdom. In three major formal debates, with Harold Eberle, debate in Oregon, Steve Gregg, a debate in Denver, Colorado, and a debate with Joel McDermott, right here in Ardmore, Oklahoma, all three men set forth the idea that one of these days, Earth will be restored to a physical utopian situation, and Jesus will rule in a physical body on the physical Earth over a physical kingdom. That simply does not fit the description of the kingdom found in the New Testament. In the last video, I shared with you the indisputable fact that Jesus taught his disciples for 40 days concerning the kingdom. And he told them, pardon me, to go into Jerusalem and wait there until they were endued with power from on high. That power was the baptism of the Holy Spirit, and that baptism of the Holy Spirit was prophesied in Joel and in Ezekiel 37 and Isaiah chapter 32, other passages, as the precursor sign for the establishment of the kingdom. But you see, what happened on Pentecost was not the establishment of a physical kingdom, not in any way, shape, form, or fashion. But let me drive that point home. And I've got to tell you, I could spend a lot of time on this. I consider this to be so exciting. And it's something that very, very few commentators take note of. There are a few, but not very many. In Acts chapter 1, Jesus told his disciples, after promising them that they would receive the Holy Spirit, he said, "You shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the other parts," pardon me, "of the earth." Well, look, folks, what Jesus was doing was citing Isaiah 43. Isaiah 43 is incredible. I probably ought to do an entire series of videos just on Isaiah 43. But Isaiah 43 foretold the time in which God would redeem his people. And he also said, he set forth his distinctive nature as God. He is God and there is none else. Now watch this. As he says to Israel, "You are my witnesses, says the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe me and understand that I am he, and before me there was no God formed, nor shall there be after me. Besides me, there is no Savior. I have declared and saved, I have proclaimed, and there was no foreign God among you, therefore you are my witnesses." Do you catch this? He said to Israel, Israel was his witnesses to proclaim that he is the true God. He is the only Savior. Now watch this. In Isaiah 43, Yahweh called on Israel to look to that time, and he said, "Do not remember the former things. Do not consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing." and it shall spring forth. So shall you know it. I will make a highway or a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. He was going to form a new, twice in this chapter, God said he was going to form a new people. That's a new Israel. Well, what's he doing in Acts chapter 1? In Acts chapter 1, you have the choosing of an apostle. So now you have 12 apostles. They're gathered together. The Holy Spirit blesses them and anoints them as the new Israel, the head of the new Israel. And the Holy Spirit is poured out on them to do what? To establish the kingdom. But did the Holy Spirit fall on them to establish an earthly, physical, visible kingdom? Absolutely not. Oh, but he said to those disciples, to those apostles, you are my witnesses. Now look, here in Isaiah 43, it is Israel that was God's witnesses. In Acts chapter 1, it is the apostles, the head of the new Israel. The old covenant leaders of the 12 tribes were the leaders of a physical, visible, earthly kingdom. The apostles were to be leaders and to sit on 12 thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel, but this would not be an earthly, physical Israel. It would not be an earthly, physical kingdom. Jesus' citation of Isaiah 43 tells us that Jesus Christ, as true deity, was doing a new thing. He was going to establish his kingdom. Israel, the new Israel, was to forget the old. But they were to proclaim him as the only one in whom salvation could be found, and thus, guess what? Peter said in Acts 4, verse 12, there's no other name given among men whereby we must be saved. Isaiah 43. When we understand Isaiah 43 serves as the template for the story of the restoration of Israel, the creation of the new people, the new kingdom, throughout the book of Acts, then we can understand the nature of the kingdom, and it absolutely is not an earthly, visible, physical kingdom. Hey, look, you really need to get my special 52-lesson series on Acts and the restoration of Israel. It will blow your mind. Go to my website, eschatology.org, BibleProphecy.com, order Acts and the Restoration of Israel. Mention that you saw the offer on YouTube or Facebook, and I'll refund your shipping. And yes, we've got a whole lot more on the nature of the kingdom. We'll see you on the flip side.